Hi, Vaughn and Claire here from Temboo.
Now you can program multiple devices with Temboo support for machine-to-machine messaging protocols like MQTT, CoAP, and HTTP. Temboo's M2M capabilities coordinate communication between distributed devices so that you can build IoT applications that are scalable, flexible, and production ready.
To demonstrate how quickly you can build your multi-device IoT application, we'll use Temboo M2M to build an application that monitors machine health and system stability for an industrial factory floor. Our gateway device will be sensing the orientation and alignment of a fabrication platform using an accelerometer. Edge device one is this TICC3200, which will be connected to a machine. This machine uses a distance sensor to detect potential obstructions. Edge device two is an Arduino Mega, which will be connected to a second machine. A piezo sensor is used to log vibration patterns, which are then sent to a Power BI dashboard. Let's see how it works.
I'm on the Temboo website, where I'll navigate to the Twilio Send SMS Choreo. We'll turn on IoT mode and select the Arctic 10 as our device. We also want to stream data to a Microsoft Power BI dashboard, which I've already set up here. This device is going to be our gateway, so I'll select MQTT for the M2M protocol that will be used. Our gateway device will also sense platform alignment. We'll go ahead and add a condition that says, if the x-axis of our accelerometer is above zero, we'll run the send SMS choreo. We can adjust this threshold in our code or convert the values to degrees depending on the required precision. I already have my Twilio credentials, including my Twilio from number, saved into a Temboo profile. I'll just add the body of the message. The platform is misaligned. Text halt to temporarily stop production. We'll add the to number of the operations manager. Next, I'll add our first edge device, a Texas Instruments CC3200 board. This edge device will be sending a PagerDuty alert to the maintenance team when an obstacle is in the way of the machine. We'll go ahead and set a condition that says, if the distance sensor has a value greater than 500, we'll trigger the alert. I already have the service key saved into a Temboo profile, so I'll add the short description, letting maintenance know that a foreign object has been detected. In the details, I'll give an indication of the machine number and the location in the factory. We also want this machine to shut off when the PagerDuty alert is sent to the maintenance team, so I'll set an output condition that says, if the PagerDuty alert was successfully sent, set the motor pin to low. Now we'll set up our second edge device. We're using an Arduino Mega with an Arduino Wi-Fi shield. Zendesk tickets will be sent to the manufacturer of the machinery when vibrations are stronger than expected. This edge device will stream vibration data to a Microsoft Power BI dashboard, giving an indication of performance over the lifetime of the machine. I already have my Zendesk credentials saved into a Temboo profile, so we'll just add those in and supply a comment for the ticket. Excessive vibration in unit 1. Check for stability patterns. For the subject, I'll add excessive vibration detected. Now our code is all set, so we'll download each snippet and upload the code to our devices. Before uploading the code to our gateway, we'll add one more feature which will allow us to remotely control our entire system. Our gateway is sending a text message to warn of improper balance of the fabrication platform. That message says text halt to stop production. We'll need to have our gateway listen to any response coming from our operations manager. I'll navigate to the Twilio get last message from number choreo. I'll add the profile containing our Twilio credentials and the operations manager's phone number. For the output condition, we'll say that if the response contains halt, set the motor pin to low. I'll add to the condition in the code to say that if the text response is on, the system should turn back on. Now that code is uploaded to each of our boards, we have an accelerometer connected to our gateway device, which will be used to detect the misalignment of our fabrication platform. So I'll just tilt it enough to hit the threshold, and our operations manager should see that SMS text.
I've just gotten the SMS. So as operations manager, I can now respond to this notification by texting halt. This will stop all the machines so that I can go and safely check our fabrication platform and make sure it's correctly aligned. Okay, everything looks good. So now I'll restart the machines by texting on. You'll also notice that our first machine right here, which is connected to our first edge device, this TI-CC3200 board, is outfitted with a distance sensor to detect any obstructions to the machinery. If I put my hand over that sensor, I will trigger a notification sent via PagerDuty.
I just received the PagerDuty alert, and the motors have stopped. We still have two motors running on our second machine, which is connected to our second edge device, or this Arduino Mega. We also have a vibration piezo sensor that's logging vibration data over time to a Power BI dashboard and will trigger a Zendesk alert to the machine manufacturers when there's a larger disturbance. So I'll just give it a quick knock and we should see that ticket come through. Here we go. The Zendesk ticket came through. It says vibration detected. So I'll just log into my Power BI dashboard and we can see the patterns over time along with the big spike from that disturbance.
A complete multi-device IoT system programmed in minutes. We can't wait to see the incredible systems that you're going to build.
Learn to build your next great application at temboo.com.